African buffalo. The African buffalo or Cape buffalo, Cincirus kaffa, is a large sub-Saharan African bovine. Cincirus kaffa kaffa, the Cape buffalo, is the typical subspecies, and the largest one, found in southern and east Africa. S. C. nanus, the forest buffalo, is the smallest subspecies, common in forest areas of central and west Africa, while S. C. brachyceros is in west Africa and S. C. equinoctialis is in the savannas of east Africa. The adult African buffalo's horns are its characteristic feature. They have fused bases, forming a continuous bone shield across the top of the head referred to as a boss. It is widely regarded as one of the most dangerous animals on the African continent, and according to some estimates it gores, tramples, and kills over 200 people every year. The African buffalo is not an ancestor of domestic cattle and is only distantly related to other larger bovines. Its unpredictable temperament means that the African buffalo has never been domesticated, unlike its Asian counterpart, the water buffalo. African buffaloes have few predators aside from lions and large crocodiles. As a member of the Big Five game, the Cape buffalo is a sought-after trophy in hunting. Description: the African buffalo is a very robust species. Its shoulder height can range from 1.0 to 1.7 meters and its head and body length can range from 1.7 to 3.4 meters. The tail can range from 70 to 110 centimeters long. Compared with other large bovids, it has a long but stocky body. The body length can exceed the wild water buffalo, which is heavier and taller, and short but thick-set legs, resulting in a relatively short standing height. Savannah-type buffaloes weigh 500 to 1,000 kilograms, with males normally larger than females, reaching the upper weight range. In comparison, forest-type buffaloes, at 250 to 450 kilograms, are only half that size. Its head is carried low, its top is located below the backline. The front hooves of the buffalo are wider than the rear, which is associated with the need to support the weight of the front part of the body, which is heavier and more powerful than the back. Savannah-type buffaloes have black or dark brown coats with age. Old bulls often have whitish circles around their eyes and on their face. Females tend to have more reddish coats. Forest-type buffaloes are 30 to 40% smaller, reddish-brown in color, with much more hair growth around the ears and with horns that curve back and slightly up. Calves of both types have red coats. A characteristic feature of the horns of adult male African buffalo, southern and eastern populations, is that the bases come very close together, forming a shield referred to as a boss. From the base, the horns diverge downwards, then smoothly curve upwards and outwards and in some cases inwards and or backwards. In large bulls, the distance between the ends of the horns can reach upwards of 1 meter, the record being 64.5 inches 164 centimeters. The horns form fully when the animal reaches the age of 5 or 6 years old, but the bosses do not become hard until it reaches the age of 8 to 9 years old. In cows, the horns are, on average, 10 to 20% smaller, and they do not have a boss. Forest-type buffalo horns are smaller than those of the savanna-type buffaloes from southern and east Africa, usually measuring less than 40 centimeters, and are almost never fused. The African buffalo is one of the most successful grazers in Africa. It lives in swamps and floodplains, as well as mopane grasslands, and the forests of the major mountains of Africa. This buffalo prefers a habitat with dense cover, such as reeds and thickets, but can also be found in open woodland. While not particularly demanding in regard to habitat, they require water daily, and so they depend on perennial sources of water. Like the plains zebra, the buffalo can live on tall, coarse grasses. Herds of buffalo mow down grasses and make way for more selective grazers. When feeding, the buffalo makes use of its tongue and wide incisor row to eat grass more quickly than most other African herbivores. Buffaloes do not stay on trampled or depleted areas for long. Other than humans, African buffaloes have few predators and are capable of defending themselves against, and killing, lions. Lions do kill and eat buffaloes regularly, and in some regions, the buffaloes are the lion's primary prey. It typically takes quite a few lions to bring down a single adult buffalo, and the entire pride usually joins in the hunt. However, several incidents have been reported in which lone adult male lions have successfully brought down adult buffaloes. The average-sized crocodile typically attacks only old solitary animals and young calves, though they can kill healthy adults. Exceptionally large, old male Nile crocodiles may become semi-habitual predators of buffaloes. This crocodilian is the only animal that typically takes down an adult buffalo alone, whereas a pride attack is the preferred method of lions when taking down such large prey. The cheetah, leopard, and spotted hyena are normally a threat only to newborn calves, though very large clans of spotted hyenas have been recorded killing cows, mainly pregnant ones, and, on very rare occasions, full-grown bulls. Thanks for watching.